Of course, is this coming Sunday, and if you want to make your very own Easter bunny, we're going to show you how. Chef David Bondarchuk from Scratch Catering Services here to show us how to make this Daybreak delight. Good morning.
Good morning, and it's so easy. It's only one ingredient.
Okay,
chocolate.
Love it. Yep.
And actually, I have to talk about this. I collect these vintage molds.
I was going to say, these look old.
Yes, these predate World War II. And actually, the FDA says that we cannot use these anymore, but I still think they're beautiful and I collect them.
They're just so pretty.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So during World War II, metals became really scarce. Mm-hmm. And so what happened was these went from being made from steel to aluminum and tin, and then they became sort of not as long as a lifespan to use them. You can see a little bit on the bunny right here, there's a little bit of rust right in there. And so when that happens and they're not properly cared for, then what happens is the chocolate will stick when you use that as a mold. So now they're really more decorative pieces.
Yeah, they're cool. This is a big one too.
Correct.
So
nowadays, this is a polycarbonate mold, and this is actually plastic. They usually come with these little chintzy, like plastic whatevers. But honestly, a great tip is to use these desk clips, and I use four to clip these two sides together. And then this is like a salad dressing container, and I just set it right in there,
it
sets right up, right?
So where do you buy these?
So you can get these online. You can also get these at any store. There's a place down over off of Broadway, and I was telling you about this for your daughter. It's a Cake and Bake.
Awesome.
And so that's a great place to go here in Denver. So the first thing you want to do is you want to temper your chocolate. And that sounds a little bit daunting, but when you melt this in the microwave on 30-second intervals on 50% power. And once it comes out and it's a little bit of, still has a little bit of lumps in there, that's exactly what you want. Then you want to shave a few more. Now I'm just using a serrated knife.
What kind of chocolate are you using?
This is milk chocolate. This is a Belgian chocolate. European chocolate is a lot different than American chocolate as far as sugar and fat content, and so you always want to use a European chocolate when you're doing this.
Can you buy this at any store?
You absolutely can. I got these large blocks at the restaurant
supply.
You can also order them online, but that's exactly what you need. And see how this is lumpy?
Yep.
What you're doing is you're adding cocoa crystals back to this chocolate. And so see right here on the edge, cameraman? You see that whiteness? If you didn't temper this right, you would get this. So you want to keep this
good. All right, so after it's all great, we got to speed this up. We just got to pour it in?
Sure, just pour it on in. And then what you want to do is, you pour this in, and it goes all the way to the top, you want to tap it lightly to get any air bubbles out of there.
Mm-hmm.
And then you're going to just refrigerate this for about an hour. And you can speed it up a little bit in the freezer, but it's fine just in your fridge.
And it's a solid milk chocolate, not the hollow ones.
Right, when you unmold it, I just put a little ribbon on it, and this came right out of that mold. What do you think?
Perfect.
And so you see this air bubble that you just want to shake it down.
All right.
And there it's full.
Homemade.
So easy, right?
Yeah, thank you, David.
Here comes Peter Cottontail.
Love it.
Happy Easter.
All right, let's talk about our entertainment news. Look at that upside down bunny.
Thanks, David.
I do love my Easter candy.
Hey, listen.
Yes, we got entertainment to get to.
Sarah wrote me an email, said that Rick Astley is going to be